Dreamweaver stencils are a fabulous tool to use for lots of different techniques. So I'm going to start you off by explaining how to use them with the paste. Now the paste is a beautiful, thick, gooey material that we put onto our stencil. Now I've taken the stencil, I've already stuck it down onto my card. Because this particular stencil is quite small, what I'm going to do is tape it down the side as well. And I'm just going to do little fold backs onto the tape so that I can lift this tape off really easy. Same at the other side, just pop that down there. Just means that we're not going to get it onto the card so much. I'm going to put a bigger piece across the top over here. And do that little fold back there in the corner as well. So my card's protected just around the outside of it. Taken my paste, and I'm going to squidge that across the top like so, making sure it's filling the width of the stencil. And using my spatula, I'm now going to pull this paste right down the stencil. So I want my spatula down nice and flat, and just pull it across. Missed a little bit up here, so again I need to keep my spatula nice and flat. The idea is that it fills in the whole of that stencil design. I'm just going to go back now, go back over, take any excess off. Try not to go across it too many times because then the paste can slide under the stencil. I'm going to pull this extra bits of paste off here. Like so. Put a lid back on our paste because we don't want it to dry out. I'm just going to pop that to the side, and now I need to take this tape off very carefully. Take that off. I'm going to pop it into this water so it's out of my way. It's very handy to have a bowl of warm soapy water at the side of you because we need to dunk the stencil immediately because we don't want the paste to stick to it. Now this is where I take this last section off, and as soon as I've got this off, I'm going to lift the stencil up with it like so, pull that back, and we've got our beautiful paste design. That's going to go in there so we can wash that off easily. Just rinse my fingers. And I'm going to take the paste off my palette knife too, because we don't want it to dry on there either. Leave that to dry and it goes this beautiful metallic gold. So easy, but really effective. The paste, of course, comes in different colours. It comes in silver, it comes in pearl. You can also use the black paste or the clear paste and sprinkle iridescent glitter onto it while it's wet. We've got copper. This is using a clear paste, and we've used an ink pad. One of the craft ink pads is great, and used a stencil brush through the stencil. So you do the first layer, pull the stencil off, clean it as I've just done, leave it to dry, pop the stencil back on, then apply colour to it. And that's how you get those beautiful tinges of colour. We've used some glitter glue in the centre of the flowers. And then last there, we have white paste on black. So this is a really fab technique and gives you a beautiful result. I'm going to put that to one side now for that to dry, and simply we can mat it up and create a lovely card from it. So I'm going to pop that one behind me over here. What I'm now going to do, I have another stencil here. This one I've already done in black paste. Let it dry and just match the design up. If I lift this off, you can see the black paste there. Match the design up and stick the stencil back on. What I'm going to do this time is use this little glue pad. It's called a stamp and stick glue pad. Now, it's a white glue pad. This comes in white and black. It's the white one that we want. And this is going to make it sticky. So what we do now is we tap this all over our design. It's a spongy ink, so we want to press it through and make sure we've got a good coverage. And then we peel this off. So we've only got the glue pad on the stencil. And then we need to heat this. Now, the tip is to sing or hum happy birthday to you twice for it to be at the right stage. So let's get this heated. It's normally about a minute and a half. I'm not going to hum it, I'm going to do it in my head. Yep, it's a little bit tacky now. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to let it cool for a minute. And then I'm going to take my gilding flakes. So remember the gilding flakes, we used these earlier with the peel off stickers. Well, what we're going to do now is pop the gilding flakes onto this image. So we've got now the gilding all over the design. As you can see, it's a muddy mess, but my texture sponge to the rescue. And then we just go over the whole of this with the texture sponge. And you can see it taking off all the little bits that we don't want. And putting those back in the pot. Let's tap that off. And you can see how the actual gilding flakes are sticking to the card. Again, I've got one that we've prepared earlier. Different colours of gilding flakes, but look how gorgeous that is. I've also done the same here with gold pearl paste underneath with gilding flakes on the top of it there. But I think the black really makes it stand out. So that's using the palette Stamp and Stick glue pad over the top of the dried paste. Now I want to show you another technique that we use as well, and this is taking the stencil. Again, we've already done the stencil in black paste and left it to dry. We've applied the stencil over the top one more time, and now I'm going to use the Versamark ink over this one. So make sure our stencil is nice and flat, and then I'm going to tap with the Versamark through the stencil. Now the Versamark we can use with Perfect Pearls. I'll just pop that to one side. I want to make sure I've got clean fingers now before I start handling the main design. So that water bottle is very handy. I'm going to take the stencil off. Now Perfect Pearls is a mica powder that has a resin in, so you can actually mix this with water. I would do that in the lid if you're going to do so, and you'll make a pearly paint. You can add it to your embossing powders, mix it in with them, and you can get that beautiful pearlescent finish with those. This way what I'm going to do is just put it onto the top of our stencil design that now has the Versamark applied. Now I can do that with these little applicators here, and they're very familiar, they're earbuds, cotton wool buds. And then I'm going to just apply this directly on top of my Versamark image. So I'm going to put the blue there, I'm going to bring the blue up onto this little petal too. Just around the edges. All the little flower heads. I'm going to change to the purple now as well. And just add purple to the tips. And green on the leaves. And a little bit of gold just blend here too. There we go. We need some dry kitchen roll. I'm that just blends it all in as well. And there you can see, with the perfect pearls applied on top of the black embossing paste with the VersaMark, and this is my finished card that I've created earlier, really is a beautiful effect. Now you can see just down here on the table, quite a few other cards that we've created with similar techniques. Some of them we've not done the embossing paste layer, but we've colored through. This one is one of my personal favorites that is using exactly the same technique as I've just shown you, the black paste first, and then the perfect pearls over it. This one is just directly through the stencil with ink pads. This one over here is embossed, dry embossed, using a light box and an embossing tool, and then inks over the top of it. And just different variations around me here on the table. The Dreamweaver range also has a crackle embossing paste, a little bit more unusual, and gives you that distressed look. It's white. You can colour on top of it, of course, with the perfect pearls or your inks. What I do advise is that you first of all do a layer in black embossing paste. Always seems to work better with the black underneath it. So you do the black, let it dry completely, and then put your paste over the top of this. So again, we need to seal this down properly onto our card. So I'm going to pop some more of the tape along the side of it. Naughty using my teeth, but they're very handy. Like so. And then take the crackle paste down, exactly the same technique. Pop this along the stencil. And then we're going to take that and work it all the way down the design. Go back, fill in any little areas if we've missed it. This we're going to pick up at the end here and put back in our pot. Pick that extra bit of paste up. There we go. Take the tape off again. And then we have to leave it to dry. Depends on room temperature. I would say about 20 minutes to half an hour for it to dry. Could take a little bit longer if the room is very cold. But you need to set it to one side and let it dry off. So I'm just lifting that off. Pop the stencil in the water. And we need to leave it to one side just to dry properly. This is one that I did earlier. And you can see here the cracks already forming in the paste. So having the black base underneath, it then shows through the actual cracks a lot better. I need to just clean this away before I forget. Don't want it drying on me. My spatula. Now, the last technique I showed you with the perfect pearls, we can use exactly the same technique for colouring this. And here's one that I've done earlier. And you can see how that beautiful perfect pearls adds the shimmer, sits on top of the crackle, and accentuates the design. A few more for you to see using the same technique. You can see our little koi carp down here. You can see the galloping horses. The cupcakes, some of my personal favourites.